Good evening. Welcome to the Underground Subway. My name is David Alston, and I am your host. And tonight we're going to talk about knowing what we need to do to be free.
To be free. I wish I could break all the chains holding me. I wish I could say all the things that I should say. Say them loud, say them clear for the whole round world to hear.
I'm David Alston. I am the host of the Underground Subway, and welcome to another edition of this podcast in which we discuss how to live a better life by being free, how to live a better life by experiencing true liberty, true freedom. Again, my name is David Alston. My grandmother was first cousins with the great Harriet Tubman, and Harriet Tubman led the Underground Railroad, and so what we're doing is we're not leading the Underground Railroad, we are leading the Underground Subway. And this podcast will discuss how to be better, how to live a better life, how to go down under that subway and come out with liberty. What is liberty? What is freedom? It is the ability to think, act, function, move, do what is necessary without restraints, and there are many restraints. In this podcast, I want to talk about knowledge and knowing something, knowing that we need to be free, and then beginning the process, because being free and living a better life is a process. And what we need to know, what we need to learn, and what we need to understand in order to live a better life. I want to start this podcast by acknowledging something that Harriet Tubman said that has really been something that's been on my mind quite a bit. And that is, she made the quote, she made the statement that I could have freed so many more slaves. I could have freed so many more that were in bondage if only they knew, if only they had an understanding, if only they had a science or a science to know that they were indeed slaves. That means that there were people who were in bondage who had the misconception that they were free, although they weren't free. And so if you do not know that you need to make a change, then you will never make a change. If you do not know that you need to do something to improve your life, you will never do it. So let's look at that during this podcast. One of the things that I want to look at is I want to read an excerpt from a book that I'm currently reading that I love. I've read it a couple times and I keep going back to it. It is called The University of Success, and it is written by Og Mandino, Og Mandino's University of Success. And in chapter, one of the lessons, chapter 29, Og Mandino writes this passage, and I want to read this, quote, "Know what you're doing. First, know what you're doing. There is no substitute for knowledge. In our approach to knowledge, we must realize that preparation is a constant process with no ending. It must be forever moving, never static. School is never out for the person who really wants to succeed. There is no saturation point. All economic research centers agree that because of the rapidly changing phases of our economy, the average person in any line of endeavor today, regardless of his particular field, must be retrained at least four times during his lifetime. Think of this." Unquote. That is powerful, because Og Mandino says that no matter how much knowledge you already have, in your lifetime, you're going to have to go through a process. You're going to have to go through Again, that word process, you're going to have to go through the process of learning all over again. It is called being a lifetime learner. It is called being someone that says, although I may know how to get from A to B, in order to get from B to C, I need to learn, because there may be instances or circumstances in which what I did to get to where I am now may not be suitable or appropriate for me to get to the next level. And so I have to put emphasis on, I have to emphasize in my own personal life the importance of knowledge. What do I need to know? Number one, I need to know that I can live a better life. I need to know, there's a saying out now, that I've heard quite a few times, that people say, I didn't come this far to come this far. That may sound redundant, but it is very true. You didn't come this far to come this far means that this isn't the end, that there's more. There's got to be more. There's a better life out there. But until you come to the realization that you need to learn more, that you need to learn how to get from here to the next level, you learn how, you've mastered how to get here. Let me put it in educational terms. A student that's in the fifth grade, they've already mastered the fourth grade and how to get to the fifth grade. That's why they're there. But in order to make the next step and move from the fifth grade to the sixth grade, that student needs to learn more. They need to learn more of what the requirements are. So let's take a look at that, the learning process. The learning process is composed of various aspects. If we look at school, and look at a student, we have to realize that the learning process involves classwork, in which you sit in a classroom, in which you learn what is required of you to go to the next level from someone who is experienced, and you do it in an environment that is conducive for learning, the classroom setting. Think about this, my friends. When you are in the classroom, everything is right for you to learn. The temperature is right, the lighting is right, the seating is right, everything is right, and it gives you the opportunity to learn or to gain knowledge. Once you finish the classroom setting, now you go home and you're given this next part, which is the homework assignment. And the homework assignment is when the teacher gives you an opportunity to put into practice at home what you practice in the classroom. Now, here's the difference. The environment at home may not be suitable for learning like the environment in the classroom. The lighting may not be correct. The seating may not be correct. The temperature may not be correct. The climate may not be correct. You may have siblings running around yelling and playing, whereas the classroom is more quiet, but it challenges you. So let's look at that. Let's look at that part. Whenever you are going to learn, whenever there is knowledge, the potential opportunity for you to gain knowledge, there's also going to be the opportunity for a challenge. Let me put it in just simple terms. Nothing comes easy. Nothing comes easy. So in order for you to learn, in order for you to have a better life, in order for that freedom to begin to flow in your life, in order for you to go into the underground subway and come out free, you are going to have to deal with and conquer the challenges that life has for you. You can't quit because you are facing a challenge. It is all a part of, remember this word that we started out with, it is all a part of the process that you must go through. And when you go through this process, when you go through the struggle or the challenge of the process, that is when the homework is completed. And once the homework is completed, now you come to the last part. You come to the part called the test. Now, the purpose for the test is simple. It is to have the teacher see or evaluate if you were able to retain what you learned in the classroom and at home. That is what the test is. It gives you an opportunity to show that I have retained the knowledge that I've gained during the process. We can't go through life and learn things about ourselves. That's one of the things that we must learn about. You must learn about yourself if you're going to be better. Here's one of the problems, my friends, in learning about ourselves. You have got to make the adjustment in life to stop looking at yourself through the eyes of others. Because when you look at yourself through the eyes of others, what will happen is you will begin to evaluate yourself based on other people's opinions of you and not the knowledge of who you are of yourself. No one knows you better than you. No one knows you better than you. I'll say it a third time. No one knows you better than you. Let me read another quote from Og Mandino's University of Success. He says, and I quote, quote, "Knowledge is accumulating so fast and methods of doing things improving so rapidly that a person today must run to stand still." That means that time is moving, and as time moves, you're going to have to gain a deeper knowledge of yourself. You're going to have to make the necessary changes. You're going to have to do what is necessary in your life to gain this knowledge. What am I saying? I'm saying that you may have to go to school. You may have to listen to more podcasts, read more books, do research to become better at who you are. But you can't be stagnant. You can't just sit there and just assume that that life is just going to give you something, that life is going to just hand you over the success that you want. One final quote from this book that says this, Og Mandino's University of Success. Quote, "Furthermore, in making this trip, the important thing is we must be constantly moving forward. Yes, the progressive realization of a predetermined goal, and our growth should never end. Any person who selects a goal in life which can be fully achieved has already defined his own limitations. When we cease to grow, we begin to die." That is the power of knowledge. When you cease to gain knowledge, when you cease to understand that you have to keep growing, that you have to keep learning and ever being a lifetime learner, being someone that just constantly just pours information into your own life. It is a shame to pour into your children, into your grandchildren, into your family, and don't pour into yourself. You have to gain that knowledge. You have to keep going. And that's what we are doing. That's what our assignment is, to keep challenging you to learn. Number one, learn about yourself. Ask yourself the question. I mentioned earlier, Harriet Tubman said, "I could have freed a lot more slaves if they only," there's that word, "knew or had a knowledge that they were still in slavery." You have to ask yourself, where am I? Where am I? You can't put in a GPS system where you're going until you first determine where you are. Where are you? Where are you in life? The next thing is, where are you going? I know where I am, but I also need to know where I'm going. In other words, what are my goals? What are my goals for myself, for my family? What are my goals? Let's look at this in the sense, let's use the analogy of a GPS system. I know where I am, and I know where I want to go. This is where I want to go. This is what my goals are in life. This is what I want to have for myself and for my children. The next thing, after I type in where I want to go, it will show me how long it's going to take to get there. That's something that you must determine as well in your quest for freedom, for a better life. How am I going to get there? What am I going to do? I know what I want, whether it's financially, whether it's relationships, whether it's career moves. I know what I want to do. Now I need to know, how am I going to get there? Not only do I need to know how am I going to achieve my goals, I need to put a time frame on it, because I'm not just going to sit by in the by and by and say, well, it will happen eventually. No, this is how long. If you put it in the GPS, it will tell you what is called an ETA, your estimated time of arrival. You should have an ETA attached to every goal that you have set forth. Write down your goals. Write down your purpose. Write down what you want to achieve, and then have an ETA beside it. I want to finish this class, and I'm not going to take 10 years to finish it. I'm going to finish it by February of next year. I want to have more money. I want to have six figures in the bank, and this is when it's going to happen. I want to have a family. I want to be married with three children. This is when it's going to happen. Whatever your goals are, I want to lose 27 pounds. And it's not going to happen overnight, and it's not going to happen by divine osmosis. I'm going to have to work toward it. But my goal is to drop this 27 pounds in 6 months, in 9 months, in a year, whatever it is. Write down your goal. And then, my friends, you have to do what Nike says. Just do it. Don't sit around staring at your goals. Once you hit, here's something that I love about this analogy of the GPS system. I know where I am. I know where I want to go. I type it in. Once I type it in, it will tell me how long it takes for me to get there. Then the last thing I do is I hit the little green button that says go. And that's what I want to challenge you to do in life as we go forward. From this day forward, I want you to have your own personal plan of where you're going. You have to know where you're going. You have to have a knowledge of how long it's going to get take you to get there. You have to have a knowledge of how to get there. But then you have to hit the go button. And that's what I'm challenging you to do today. Do what you need to do to hit the go button. And once you hit the go button, it will tell you starting route to wherever it is you're going. And we're going to get there together, because we will be free. We will not sit by another day and be lost and be in bondage. We're going to be free. I appreciate you, and I appreciate you allowing me to motivate you. I appreciate you allowing me to push you. I appreciate you allowing me to be the one to drag you out of bondage and into a better life on the underground subway. I'm David Alston, host of the Underground Subway, and I'll see you next time right here. Look yourself in the mirror before you go to bed tonight and ask yourself, did I do something to work toward my goals and my destiny, or did I waste another day? I'll see you. Peace and purpose right here on the Underground Subway.
I wish I could share all the love that's in my heart. Remove all the bars that keep us apart. I wish you could know what it means to be me, then you'd see.